Students, in this video, we are going to learn about sex determination in different types of organisms. Sex determination. First of all, you should know what do you mean by sex determination. Actually, sex determination is a method by which the male and female individual in a species can be distinguished. So that method is called as sex determination. So in the case of dioecious organisms, what do you mean by dioecious organism? Means unisexual organism. It may possess only one sex organ, either ovary or testis. Such organisms are called as dioecious organisms. So in the case of dioecious organisms, sex chromosomes determine the sex of individual. The chromosomes other than sex chromosomes are called as autosomes. And the sex chromosomes, in the case of dioecious organisms, the sex chromosomes may be similar in one sex. Okay, so that condition is called as homomorphic. And in the case of other sex, the sex chromosomes are dissimilar. That condition is called as heteromorphic. The individual having homomorphic sex chromosome produces only one type of gamete. So that condition is called as homogametic. And heteromorphic individual produces two types of gamete. That condition is called as heterogametic. Okay. Now we are going to see about chromosomal basis of sex determination. So first we are going to see about how, so the chromosomal basis possesses many types of sex determination. So first we are going to see about heterogametic sex determination. Okay, in this method, one of the sex produces similar gamete. Okay, they are called as homogametic individual. The other sex produces dissimilar gametes. They are called as heterogametic individual. Okay, and because of this homogametic and heterogametic nature, the sex of the fetus or the offspring is determined only at the time of fertilization. So here first we are going to see about heterogametic males. In the case of heterogametic male, the males are heterogametic and females are homogametic. See this tabular column. So in the case of heterogametic males, there are two types. One is XX, X0 type and XX, XY type. So first two pairs of chromosome represents female. The next two pairs of chromosomes represents male. Okay, these two are female and these two are male. Okay, so in the case of female, they are homogametic. They produce only one type of gamete. And in the case of male, they are heterogametic. So they produce two types of gamete. So see this picture here. These are parents. So female, male. So female is homogametic, they possess two X chromosome, and males are heterogametic, they possess one X chromosome and unless there is no sex chromosome, only one sex chromosome, that is X chromosome. So they produce here, them as females are homogametic, they produce only one type of gamete. That means they possess one set of autosome and only one X chromosome. And in the case of male, as they are heterogametic, they produce two types of sperm. Here, one sperm possesses one set of autosome and one X chromosome. And another sperm, they possess one set of autosome and there is no sex chromosome. Okay, so when the sperm which possesses one X chromosome fuses with the egg, it produces female offspring. And the sperm which do not possess any sex chromosome fuses with the egg, it produces male. Okay, so here they are heterogametic, so they possess only one X chromosome. So the example for heterogametic male, so XX, X0 type are bugs, cockroaches and grasshoppers. So next type is XX, XY type. In the case of XX and XY type, see males are heterogametic, so they can produce two types of gamete. So one sperm possesses only one X chromosome and another sperm possesses only one Y chromosome. But in the case of female, they are homogametic, they produce only one type of gamete which possesses only one X chromosome. Okay. So the sperm which possesses X chromosome fused with egg, it produces female. And the sperm which possesses Y chromosome fused with female gamete, it produces XY type, that is a male individual. Examples for XX, XY type are humans and Drosophila. So next one is heterogametic female. In the case of heterogametic female, males are homogametic and females are heterogametic. So see this tabular column. So heterogametic female. Okay, here it is divided into two types, that is Z0 and ZZ. So this is female and ZZ is male. And next type is ZW and ZZ. ZW is female and ZZ is male. So here the females are heterogametic, males are homogametic. See this, here the females are heterogametic. So they produce two types of egg. So one egg possesses, one type of egg possesses only one Z chromosome. Other type of egg do not possess any sex chromosome. Okay. And the sperm are homogametic, they produce only one type of sperm. Okay. So when the sperm fuses with the egg which possesses only one Z chromosome, that develop into male. And the sperm which fertilize the egg which possesses no sex chromosome will develop into female. So example for this type of sex determination is moths, butterfly and domestic chicken. So the next type is ZW, ZZ type. In this case, female possess ZW, two types of sex chromosome, and male possess only one type of sex chromosome. So female possess two, produces, female produces two types of egg. So one egg, one type of egg with Z chromosome, another type of egg with W chromosome. But male possess produces, but male produces only one type of sperm that possesses only one Z chromosome. So when the sperm fused with the egg containing Z chromosome, then that will develop into male. So this is Z. And when the sperm fused with the egg containing W chromosome, that will develop into female. So example for ZW, ZZ type is gypsy moth, fishes, reptiles and birds. So next we are going to see about sex determination in human beings. So in the case of human beings, the genes which are determining the sex of human beings are located in two sex chromosomes. So these sex chromosomes are called as allosomes. So in the case of mammals, the sex determination is associated with chromosomal differences between two sexes. Okay, different types of chromosome present in two sexes, male and female. So in the case of female, so female possess two X chromosomes, and in the case of male, he possess one X chromosome and one Y chromosome. This is the chromosomal difference. So based on this only, the sex of the human being is determined. So usually in the case of human being, there are 46 chromosomes, that is 23 pairs of chromosomes are there. Of this 23 pairs, 22 pairs of chromosomes are autosomes. So that is represented as 44A. And one pair is the allosome, that is sex chromosome. It may be either, if it is female, so then the allosomes are XX. And if it is male, then the allosomes are XY. So from this, we can understand that females are homogametic. That means she can produce only one type of gamete. So that gamete contains only one X chromosome. In the case of male, they are heterogametic. They produce two types of gametes. So the gamete may possess one X chromosome or one Y chromosome. See, father, that is male, possesses 44, that is autosome, plus two sex chromosome, that is XY. In the case of mother, 44 autosomes and two X chromosomes, that is sex chromosome. Okay, so male can produce two types of sperm, that is sperm that possesses one X chromosome, sperm that possesses one Y chromosome. But in the case of female, she can produce only one type of egg. That means the egg contains only one X chromosome. Okay. So when the egg is fertilized with the sperm containing X chromosome, then the offspring will be the girl child. Okay. If an egg is fertilized by the sperm containing Y chromosome, then that child will be the boy. Okay. So next we are going to see about how this Y chromosome determines the development of male. Actually, Y chromosome has genes and also regions potential for genetic function. Okay. So it has a region with genetic function and also it has some genes. It has some genes. Okay. These genes are with or without counterpart to the X chromosome. Okay. This genes which are present in the Y chromosome may be or may not be similar to that of the X chromosome. Okay. And these genes are present at both the end of the Y chromosome. So such genes are called as autosomal regions. That is PAS, P-A-R-S. So this is the region which is homologous to the X chromosome. So these regions are called as PAS, P-A-R. Okay. So what is the use of this PARS, PARS are these similar regions. So the region similar to this region is found in X chromosome. So they will undergo recombination during meiosis. They will synapse. Synapse means pairing up. They will pair up and recombine during meiosis. Okay. So this region is about only 5%. The remaining 95% of Y chromosomes are non-combining region of Y, that is NRY, non-combining region of Y. Okay, so this non-combining region of Y is divided into two. They are euchromatic region and heterochromatic region. Euchromatic regions are nothing but functional region. They possess the functional gene. The genes which are present in the euchromatic region alone express. And the case of heterochromatic region, they are non-functional region. That means the genes which are present in this region do not expressed out. That is called as heterochromatic region. Okay. And this euchromatic region has a gene that is called as sex determining region Y. SRY. This region is found in euchromatic region. And this region is absent in X chromosome. Okay. So the absence of Y chromosome in the zygote. Okay. So that will lead to develop into female. Okay. Why means this SRY region is absent in X chromosome. Okay. And what is the use of this SRY gene means? It produces testis determining factor. This gene only produces the factor that is testis determining factor. This factor helps in the development of testis. Okay. This factor is found in adult male testis. So these are all the euchromatic region. So other regions are heterochromatic region. Okay. So next we are going to see about dosage compensation or Bohr bodies. In 1949, Bohr, Bertram, okay, they first observed a condensed body in the nerve cells of female cat, but this condensed body are absent in male. Okay. And they call this content body as sex chromatin. Okay. Later it was named as Bohr bodies. Okay. So why this contents to body present in female means. So you know that male possess only one X chromosome. But female possess two X chromosome. Okay. So here there is a difference in the X chromosome dosage between male and female. So in order to compensate that dosage of X chromosome in male and female, so one of the X chromosome get inactivated in female. Okay. So because of this inactivation of one of the X chromosome, now both male and female have only one functional X chromosome. Okay. So now the dosage get compensated. How this X chromosome get inactivated means. Okay, that is explained by Lyon's hypothesis. Okay, Mary Lyon suggested that, okay, Bohr bodies are nothing but the inactive chromosome. Okay, they represented that these Bohr bodies are represented as inactive chromosome. Okay, So how this inactive chromosomes are formed means, in the case of female, one of the X chromosome get tightly coiled into heterochromatin, okay, and they get condensed and they form a visible chromatin. Okay, and here the number of Bohr bodies observed in a cell is one less than the number of X chromosome. So for example, if a female possesses only one X chromosome, then there is no Bohr bodies. But if a male who possesses X chromosome as XXY, so here that male possesses one Bohr body. See this example here. This is normal female. So she possesses two X chromosome. So here one of the X chromosome get condensed and become Bohr body. This is normal male. He possesses only one X chromosome. So there is no Bohr bodies. Male is XXY male. So that is Klinefelter syndrome. Here the male possesses two X chromosome. So there is one Bohr body in his cell. The last example, triple X female, that is super female, possesses as there is one more X chromosome is there, one extra X chromosome is there. She possesses two Bohr bodies. So according to this, so number of Bohr body in a cell is one less than the number of X chromosome possess or present in the cell. So next topic, that is haplodiploidy in honeybees. So haplodiploidy is a method which is common in hymenopteran insects like honeybees, ants and wasps. So in this mechanism, the sex of the offspring is determined by the number of sets of chromosomes it receives. So you know about honeybees. In honeybees, the females are developed from fertilized egg. The females are queen and workers. And the males developed from unfertilized egg. They are drones. Okay. So the males in honeybees are developed by parthenogenesis. Okay. So because of this, the male possesses only the half the number of chromosome haploid. Okay. And the female possesses double the number of chromosome. They are diploid. Okay. Hence it is named as. So haplodiploidy of sex determination. So next is kin selection. So kin selection explains how this haplodiploidy facilitates the evolution of sociality. Okay, you know that honeybees are social insects, isn't it? So he explained that how this haplodiploidy facilitates the evolution of sociality in this mechanism. So only, that means in the case of honeybee, only one female becomes queen and it lays the egg for its colony. Females, what about the all other females? It helps to raise queen's egg and thus it contributes to queen's reproductive success, and also indirectly it helps to their womb. Okay, so if it takes care of the queen and its egg, then automatically its own race also develop. Okay, so this phenomena is called as kin selection. And here, how this queen is constructing the social environment means it releases a hormone. This hormone suppresses the fertility of workers. Okay, thereby the workers become infertile. So it is this workers not able to, they cannot able to lay the egg. So thus the queen constructs her social environment. So that is the kin selection. See, this is the male development and this is male development and this is female development. Here diploid female bee, it lay egg. Okay, so it will undergo meiosis. Okay, during gamete formation, meiosis, meiotic cell division occur. So thus it produces the egg with half the number of chromosome. Okay, so without fertilization, the haploid male bees develop from the unfertilized egg. But in the case of female development, okay, the female which is diploid, it will undergo meiotic cell division, thus it produces haploid egg, haploid gamete. Okay, but in the case of male, it is haploid only, so there is no meiosis. It will the cell division is only mitotic and it produces a haploid sperm. Okay, they fuse together. Okay, thus it carry out the fertilization, thus produces diploid female bees. Okay, students. So here you learned the different types of sex determination in organisms. Thank you.